Okay everyone, so now we are learning the while loop. While loop is the part of looping. We know that whenever we have to repeat something, then looping comes. Let's say we are creating some program. In this program, let's say there are some set of lines. Let's say three lines are there. If I want that line number two should be repeated multiple times, now this is called the looping. Means if I have to repeat this line multiple times, let's say if I want to print number five times, I will not write the statement five times, I will apply the looping. Now inside the looping we are having while, do while, for, do until. So multiple loops are there. With the help of that we can perform the looping. Now here is the while loop which we are learning. To understand the while loop, first of all we are taking one example. Let us suppose that we are having certain numbers. We are starting the number with 1, then we are having the 3, then 5, then 7. So these are the four numbers that I want to print here. If we talk about any of the looping, there are three things we should understand. The first thing is the initialization. The second thing is condition. And the third thing is increment or decrement. We should understand that initialization means from where your loop will start. Now very first value from where your loop start is called the initialization. So here one is the initialization. If we go with the syntax of while loop, so first of all we have to take certain variable. Let's say if I am taking a variable I here, now I will initialize it. So I will be equal to 1 because we know that the starting value is 1. Second thing we are having is the condition. We should understand that the last value till where the loop is going, that is called the condition. So here our condition will be ending till 7. We know that we started with 1 and 1 will reach to 7. So 1 is less than. And here we are going till 7, that's why the condition will become less than equal to 7. Because we can see that here the loop is going till 7. That's why this 7 is the condition. And less than equal to, because I have started with 1, 1 is less than and we are going till 7. So equal to, so less than equal to 7. So here in the condition, we will write I less than equal to 7. So here this is the condition. Now first of all we will be writing this while, then afterward the condition. So here we have performed the condition I less than equal to 7. So this one is the condition we have applied, I less than equal to 7. Now the third thing is increment or decrement. Now that we have to decide. First of all we should check first and second number, what is the difference. If I see that 1 is going till 3, so 3 minus 1, you check it, 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. So here 2, that means this 2 is the difference and it is into the positive. So we can see that this is the increment here because 2 is the positive number. So this time we are dealing with the increment. So that means the value of I should be incrementing with 2. So before ending the while, we will apply here I is equal to I plus 2. Let's say if you are taking the value 3, so you will be right I is equal to I plus 3. This way whatever the difference is there, you will apply. In terms of decrement, you will apply I is equal to I minus 2. So here we have performed the three things. One is the initialization, second one is the condition, and third one is the increment or decrement. And here we are having one more thing, which is the statement. In this statement we will write the print statement. Let's say if I want to print the value of I, so we will write here print the value of I. Let's say I am using this p, p is for printing. Now here I am using print the I. Now we are understanding that how this syntax will work. First of all we will be going I equal to 1, so wherever the I is there, the initialize to 1. Afterward it will be going on the while loop. This is the syntax, means you have to apply this while. And then it will be going to the condition check. Is I less than equal to 7? We can check that. Is 1 less than equal to 7? Yes, true. If the part is true, it will come inside and execute the statement. So first of all, it will print this. So 1 will be printed. Then afterward, it will be going to the next line. I will be equal to I plus 2. So the new value of I will be 1 plus 2 is 3. So it will be 3. Then afterward, we'll be going back and again checking the condition. And again, we can see that I less than equal to 7, 3 less than equal to 7, perfectly fine. Again, it will be going inside. So again, it is going and just printing it. So 3 will be printed. And again, afterward, it will be going I is equal to I plus 2. So again, 3 will be 5. Again, going back and checking the condition. And here, 5 less than equal to 7, perfectly fine. Again, it will go and check the condition, and afterward, it will be going and printing this. So 5 will be printed. Then afterward, again increment it. I is equal to I plus 2. So the value of I will be now 7. Again, going back and checking, is I less than equal to 7? Is 7 less than equal to 7? Perfectly fine. Again, it will be going and printing this. So here 7 will be printed. Again, it will be going and I is equal to I plus 2. So here the value of I will be now 9. Now again, going back and checking the condition, is I less than equal to 7? Is 9 less than equal to 7? No. Here the condition is false. So afterward, it will be not going inside. It will be directly going outside. So here is the end while. So this is how the while loop work. Now we are taking a real life program. With the help of that, we will understand the while loop. So here is the program of while loop. Now first of all, we have created a form in the .NET application. Afterward, we have taken a label. So this is the label one. I am assuming that this is the L1 for the label one. Then we have dragged and dropped one button, let's say B1. Now in this button, we have given the name click. Now we double click on the button, then this coding was performed. So here we are having public class form one. So this form one belong to this class. Now public because this form will be accessed outside. Now this class is having the end class. Afterward, this button is having the coding, which is sub. Sub stands for void. It is for the void function. Now button one underscore click, this is the name of function. Now private because button is the part of the form, it is not outside, that's what is private. Sub is going with the end sub, so this is one part. Now two arguments are passed, this is first argument, this is the second argument, both are the by value method, and it is handling the button one dot click event. Means whenever you click on this button, then the event will be performed. Event means this action, whatever the coding we are done, will be performed. Now inside the button coding, we are writing one single quote and afterward while loop. Now this green line shows that this is the comment. Compiler not read the comment, it will not be executed while performing the program. Dim I as integer, so one variable I is declared as the integer type. Then label one dot text equal to blank. So this label one, whatever the text was inside is label one, is now is becoming blank. The reason is that whenever we are going to concatenate with the other string, then this label one we don't want. We want that their value should be blank. We know that in the looping there are three things. One is the initialization, then second one is the increment or decrement, and then third thing is the condition check. So here, if we are not initializing the I here into the .NET, automatically I will be zero. Because whenever you declare any variable, .NET automatically make it zero. So the value of I is zero right now. Then afterward, while I less than 5. So this zero is less than 5, perfectly fine. This is the condition check. Now afterward, it will be going inside. Label one dot text will be equal to the earlier value. We know that the earlier value we have made was blank. So the blank concat with one more blank and I. What is I? I is 0. So first 0 we have taken into the label 1. So you can see that the label 1 is now modified with 0. Then afterward, going to the next line, I is equal to I plus 1. So I is now 1. Then afterward we'll be going back. So here it is going and checking the condition. I less than equal to 5. 1 less than 5. Perfectly fine. Condition true. So coming inside, previous value concat with the new value. We know that the previous value was 0. So concat with new value of I, which is 1. So 1 is taken. Then afterward, I is equal to I plus 1. So the value of I is now 2. Again going back and checking the condition. I less than 5. 2 less than 5 is true. So coming inside, then previous value with the new value. We know that the previous value is 0 and 1. With the new value is 2. So here the 2 is now printed. Then afterward, I is equal to I plus 1. So the value of 2 is now 3. Again going back, afterward checking the condition, I less than 5, 3 less than 5, perfectly fine. So here again going inside, previous value concat with space and the new value. So the previous value is 0, 1, 2, concat with the new value which is 3. So 3 is also taken. Then afterward I is equal to I plus 1, so now the value of 3 is 4. Again going back and checking the condition, I less than 5, so 4 less than 5 is true. Then afterward, all the previous values 0, 1, 2, 3 concat with the new value of I. So here, the previous value 1 space and the new value is taken. Now I is equal to I plus 1. So now 4 is incremented to 5. Again going back, and afterward it is checking the condition I less than 5. So 5 less than 5, this is false. Now when the condition become false, it will be not going inside, it will be directly going outside the while, and afterward end while. So after the end while it will be going. So here there is no further line available, that's why we are having this output available, which is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is how we can apply the while loop, and this is all about the while loop.